Namaskar. Hello and welcome to P Guru's channel. I'm your host, Sri Iyer. I have today with me Sri T.G. Mohandas, and he is going to talk about what is malicious prosecution and what kind of tools do people like Maridas or Kishore Swami have to seek justice from what one can call is malicious prosecution, because this has been done with no basis. Some of the lawsuits that they were put on had no basis, and they have been set aside. But one of the things that was happening was that Kishore K. Swami was put under Gunda's Act, and he had to school his heels for 6 months in a jail. Who's going to give him back those 6 months? What kind of a redressal does he have? Does the Constitution provide for this? Do we have cases of malicious prosecution where the innocents have got justice? All this and more from engineer turned entrepreneur turned lawyer, Sri Mohandas T.G. Mohandas T.G., Namaskar and welcome to P Guru's channel.
Namaste. So happy to meet you again on a fantastic subject.
Mohandas ji, my video is frozen, but I'll fix it, but I'll let you continue. So I'll do it right after I post a question to you, sir. This recent case of Maridas as well as Kishore Swami, that they were incarcerated for what I would call as frivolous, trumped up charges. These things have really, you know, shaken some of the right-wingers, because these are all deemed as right-wingers in Tamil Nadu. And was it done to try and muzzle the voices, or was there any basis on this? But having done all that, they have come out, they still have a few cases, but is there a recourse for them? Can they take a case-by-case approach and try and get justice from this system? Your thoughts on, you yourself have had a personal experience, so kindly share with us your thoughts on this subject.
See, first of all, I would like to congratulate the Hindu warriors, the nationalist warriors in Tamil Nadu, who are fighting for Hindus or our civilization. I would call it a wounded civilization. I congratulate them for their individual fight as well as collective fight. Now, just imagine that you are fighting against the might of the state. Many of the people think that you are fighting radical Islam, you are fighting rationalist anti-Hindus. It's not so. It is partially true, but you are fighting against the might of the state, be it DMK or AADMK, or in Kerala, if you come, be it LDF or UDF. In center also, I would say, be it UPA or NDA, you are fighting against the might of the state, which is unimaginable. The resources at their command, the money, the weapon, the people, the police, the military, the judiciary, the administration, the IAS lobby, the IPS lobby, the underground lobby, the goons, the quotation gangs, which a state can employ against you, is so huge that they can overpower you within 2 or 3 hours. They can demolish your house. They can kill your relatives. They can keep you under custody on some grounds or the other. They have all sorts of law which can silence you. In fact, in India, government is the biggest mafia. I know I make this statement with responsibility. The government is the biggest mafia in India. You just cannot fight them. But they have some vulnerable points wherein if you are a Naxalite, if you are an urban Naxalite, or if you are a radical Islamist, if you are a Islamic fundamentalist, you can get away with whatever you do, because this type of forces are having an indirect control over the administration. They will take care of you. It is not because you are a great man. It is because you belong to their fold, they are protecting you. The moment you fall out from that gang, they will abandon you and the state will pounce upon you. This is a fact in India. And by and large, the judiciary is also a part of that. Now I will tell you how to fight it. We have to fight it because we are the greatest civilization and we are the probably the most wounded civilization in the world. No civilization was wounded like this. Even today, the memory of our wounds are alive. The blood is still oozing from our wounds. And when we fight for that, we are called Hindu fundamentalists. You go to the fundamentals of Hindus, that is the most generous system in the world. So I would like myself to be called a Hindu fundamentalist because my fundamentals are so liberal that I am proud about that. But then practically, when somebody calls you Hindu fundamentalist, they equate you with the Islamic fundamentalists. For them, all religions are same, Hindu, Christian, Islam. All three are same. Therefore, you fight for Hindu cause, you become a Hindu fundamentalist. Anyway, whatever they want to call name, let them call it. But please be clear in your mind that you are fighting for the greatest civilization on earth, which was wounded for centuries, and the wounds are still bleeding, and people behave, the administration behave as if nothing has happened. Sometimes people behave that BJP is in power, now I can go and sleep. No, BJP is in political power, not in civilizational power. They have a long way to go to arrest the civilizational power and assert the Hindu civilization. Uske liye bahut aage jana hai. I am not blaming them. They have, every political party has got their limitations, electoral problems, all these things I understand. So I am not blaming them. I am telling you the situation. Therefore, what is that an individual can do? The individual fighters, they are in trouble because they represent this civilization. They feel very much for their civilization, the Hindu civilization. So they just cannot hold back. Therefore, they go and fight alone. Good. Very good. You must do that. But first of all, I will say that understand the might of the state. Don't underestimate the state and police. Number two, if not anybody else, please ensure that your wife is standing with you. You have a family. You are the protector of the family. You are the backbone of the family. It is not that if you are killed, the whole family will vanish. Nothing like that. Your family will still may or may not flourish. That is in God's hand, we don't know. But as of now, you are the backbone of that family. Your wife will not like you to sacrifice your life for the sake of your civilization. So ensure the safety of your wife. Who will come rushing to rescue you when you are in trouble. don't depend on politics, like BJP or RSS, Vishwa Hindu Parishad. All these organizations, they have members. Members are not automatically friends. Be friends also. Members could be friends also. But members need not necessarily be friends. But your old friends in your school days, your college days.
Viewers, we seem to have momentarily lost Sri T.G. Mohandas, but he will be joining us very, very shortly. So kindly stay tuned. May I request every one of you to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. As of now, you can like this video. I'd like to see a lot more likes on this video so that this will get more traction in the YouTube search sphere. Thank you very much. And we are waiting for Sri Mohandas Ji to rejoin. It may have been an incoming phone call or something like that. He's just rejoined. Here we go. Yes, sir. Please continue.
Yeah. So he may be a Christian, Muslim or Sikh, whosoever he may be. He is your friend. He loves you out of nothing. He may or may not agree with your cause. But because he is your friend, he will help you when you are in trouble. Develop this type of friendship, which has no bearing on ideology or anything. Pure friendship on humanity's ground. Keep a good relation with all political leaders. Never ever think that every politician is bad. Oh, they are DMK, they are anti-Hindu. Aisa nahi hai. No. Every DMK leader is not anti-Hindu. Every DMK leader is not an atheist. Those times are over after Karunanidhi or even probably Annadurai. All DK, DMK people have changed. They go to temple, they worship. For political reasons, they are against you. Keep a good relation with them. So whenever you are in difficulty, some local DMK man will speak to the police or to speak to the higher-ups and then see that you are not harassed. He will speak to them and tell them that he is a Hindu warrior. Okay, I don't agree with him, but don't trouble him too much. He is my friend. This is the way politicians interfere. So never ever think that every politician is against you. Those who are not with you are not necessarily against you. They may not be with you, but they are not against you. So this type of friendship is to be cultivated with the police, serving police, retired police, and live politicians and retired politicians. Keep a good relation with anybody so that people will understand that this is a good man who has taken up a good cause, which may be politically incorrect. In the heart of heart, everybody knows that this is Hindu civilization. This is to be protected. But for various reasons, for money, somebody for wine, somebody for women, somebody for position, somebody for politics, they compromise. But in the heart of heart, everybody knows that this is the right thing to be done in India. Right thing to be done in India. Therefore, when you are in trouble, this type of people will help you. I am telling you all these things because everything cannot be settled legally. The Indian legal system is taking too much time so that people become impatient and they leave it halfway. I am not blaming judiciary. Judiciary has their own limitations, problems. Anyway, that has got accumulated, and we are in a situation that the dispensation of justice has become a rare thing in India. And what we can do? We cannot go on fight with the institutions. So we have to carefully tread through the open areas of all these institutions and reach our goal. So what will happen? You take up a Hindu course and for some reason the police is against you. They have arrested you. First you make a complaint to not even first, the parallel complaint should go to police complaint authority. There is a police complaint authority in every state. You send an email to them that I am being arrested for all wrong reasons, etc. This is where you need your wife or your friend. Your old friend will draft an email for you and send it to police complaint authority, state human rights commission, national human rights commission, the chief minister and the state police chief and the jurisdictional magistrate. District magistrate means district collector in Kerala and Tamil Nadu. The district collector is the district magistrate. Send mail to all these people. Send it to chief minister. Send it to home minister. Keep the issue live. Use the social media always effectively. Go on shouting in the social media that I am arrested, I am being harassed, this, that. In spite of that, you can be arrested because you are a small man. Nobody knows you even in social media. Maybe 4 or 5 followers in Twitter, 10 or 15 likes in your Facebook. You are a very small man, even in social media. I understand. I have suffered through that. That is why I'm telling you. Even then, don't leave it there. Go on campaigning that I am under arrest. And depending on your resources, go to High Court. High Court is the best place to interfere in this manner. Your advocate will present it properly. You see, in 1997, the Supreme Court has put certain guidelines for arresting a human being. Because arresting a human being is not a small thing. Arresting means intimidating you, preventing you from going outside, or confining you in a small place. All these things are called arrest. There is no clear legal definition for arrest. Therefore, there are so many judges who have interpreted the word arrest. Anyway, in 1997, Supreme Court once for all said that if you are arresting a person, the following things are to be followed. A record is to be maintained, who is arresting, the man who is arresting you should have a name badge or his token number on his chest, etc., etc. Several things are there. And you know, an arrest is nearly impossible as stipulated by Supreme Court. Because the strictures are so stringent that no police station will be able to arrest you. Therefore, they violate one or two conditions which Supreme Court has stipulated. You can approach the High Court. You can say that B.K. Basu judgment is violated. Therefore, I must be released. This is one way of doing it. Anyway, in your friend circle, please ensure that one or two lower court, the advocates who are practicing in lower court advocates are to be your friends, not High Court. If you have lower court advocates as your friends, you can approach High Court also through them. So one or two friends are needed in lower court also. These are the things which have to be done when you are arrested maliciously. Now, what is malicious prosecution? That is another problem. Imagine that you have been falsely implicated in a case and you won the case. After winning, you can sue the officer who charged you with a false case. That is called malicious prosecution. This happens after you get the judgment. After you are let scot-free by the court, then you can start malicious prosecution against the officer who has charged you. Therefore, your intention always has to be to close your case as early as possible. And you will see the prosecution and the police will try to drag it as late as possible. Yes, sir.
Mohandasji, your voice is coming across a little bit garbled. Could you kindly log off and log back in? Log off and log back in.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you. And yours, Sri Mohandasji's voice is coming a little garbled. So we're going to try and get him to log back in, and hopefully that will solve that problem. And in the meantime, I hope you are staying safe and at home and not taking any unnecessary risks. Thank you very much, sir. Please continue.
Yeah, I was speaking without knowing that you are not listening. Where shall I start again?
No, you are going to say that you can sue the officer who arrested you. You can start from there. And then you also said that you want it done as quickly as possible. And the other side, since they know it is a trumped up charge, is going to try and delay it as far as possible. That's where we stop.
Exactly. Every police officer will try to drag you up. So try to finish it off as quickly as possible.
For which
you need a smart advocate in the lower court. All these things are happening in the lower court. If you go to high court, you don't have this much control. But lower court, you can insist that my case is to be heard next day. All these things are possible in lower court. Even in high court, it is possible. If you are a well-known personality, high court may entertain such requests. But lower court, it is possible. You can request for early hearing. And if they are not acceding to your request, you can approach high court for an early hearing. So that high court will instruct the lower court that, please finish this within 6 months. You have been harassing this man for quite long. So within 6 months, the lower court has to clear this. And since you are innocent, you will be proclaimed innocent and start your malicious prosecution case against the policeman who filed a case against you. By the time, mind you, by the time he might have been retired, he may be living peacefully, a man of 63 or 64 years old, living in an obscure village in Tamil Nadu. People will advise you, "Are bhai chhod do, poor man, why are you troubling him now?" No. Never accede to such requests. Proceed against him so that a signal, a strong signal goes to everybody that, like karma, the law will catch you up whether you are in service or out of service. I have seen several Hindu warriors. They feel so sad about the police officers who harass them merely because a police officer had a paralytic shock. He is lying in hospital. He is getting hardly 20,000 rupees pension. His wife is in trouble. Oh, why should I sue him now? Okay, jo ho gaya, ho gaya. No, sue him. Remember the words of Krishna. When Arjuna was hesitant to attack Karna, who had one of his wheels strangled in the mud, Arjuna said, "No, I should not kill him now." Krishna said, "No, this is the opportunity. Kill him. Kill him. Kill the dharma when you get a chance." Never have this type of misplaced charity in your mind. He may be sick, He may be in hospital bed. He may be unconscious, but sue him and send a message to the living people who are in the service, so that they will get a message that one day we will be caught. Even in death bed, the law will catch us. Therefore, let us be very careful with the Hindu variants. This is what is Hindutva has taught us. We think, forgive and forget, that is a big thing. It's a big thing. I understand, it's a big thing. But whom to forgive and forget? Somebody who is requesting forgiveness, you can forgive him. On personal grounds, you can forgive somebody. Nothing wrong in that. When you have a personal problem with somebody, even if he doesn't apologize, you can forgive him. The problem with Hindus, and particularly with Hindu warriors, that you feel these individual values are the ultimate. Aisa nahi hai. There are values for the society and values for individual. As an individual, you can be silent for 1 month, is it not? Maun Vrat. 1 month you can be silent. Suppose this value is taken by our Prime Minister Narendra Modi and he says that I am under Maun Vrat for 1 month, what will happen to the country? So, see, dharma is different when you are an individual and when you are leading a society. When you are a husband, the dharma is different. When you are a brother, it is different. When you are a friend, it is different. When you are a judge, it is different. Your policeman is a different. Advocate is a different. That is why we have different code of conduct for different professions. It is as simple as that. So, never pardon your enemy, because punishing your enemy is sending a signal to your potential enemy. Therefore, I would request everybody to use every legal opportunity which I have told. I will sum up now. It is lodging a complaint before you are implicated, or before you get a final judgment in any case. When you are arrested, you are freshly arrested, you are remanded into judicial custody or police custody. At that time, what you should do is that, number one, complain to the magistrate whenever you are produced in front of the magistrate. You say that you are being abused, you are being physically attacked, so that he will send you to the hospital. You will be out of jail, you can be in hospital. All these things are possible. Then ask your friend, or if you can, if the police is allowing, you can do it directly. Lodge a complaint with the police complaint authority. Lodge a complaint immediately with the State Human Rights Commission, National Human Rights Commission. Send an email to the Chief Minister, Home Minister, and the State Police Chief, by whatever name he called. Somewhere it is Director General of Police, somewhere it is State Police Chief. Anyway, the top man of the police. Keep on sending messages to them, to the district superintendent of police. Everybody, you send messages. Keep your friends ready. It is not that every time you disturb them. No. This type of crisis will come once in a blue moon. And your friend, a non-political friend, will support you. Take it from me. A non-political friend. I have friends in almost every party, including CPM in Kerala. And I know if I am in distress, they will at least try to help me, because they know this man is sincere. He is not corrupt. He is fighting for a good cause. We don't support him openly because of political reasons. But what Mohandas says is true. They know that everybody, every human being, especially Bharatiya, is having a dharma consciousness in his mind. Touch that and he becomes your friend. Never have any selfish interests when you are fighting for Hindus. Never hanker for publicity. Never hanker for approval or validation by somebody. Be sincere. The society, the Indian society, even today, will appreciate sincerity and integrity. So please, my friends in Tamil Nadu, I am wishing you all the best. Carry on with your fight. I am at your beck and call. You can contact me at any time. You can contact me through Sri Iyer. I'll be, whatever little I could do, definitely I will do through the court, through my contacts, or through social media. Whatever help you need, definitely I will do. This is my solemn assurance to you. Thank you.
Excuse me. Excuse me. Mohandasji, that was a wonderful preamble, and I have a few observations for you. One is that we may have a couple of questions that I'll ask you, but before that, you've had a personal experience of being confronted slash ill-treated slash abused by an officer of the law, meaning police official, and you had to face this thing yourself. So can you please walk us through that real life experience so that people understand where it begins, how it begins, and where it ends, and how it ended?
I will tell you that. See, there was a forum in Kerala which was floated in support of Abdul Nasser Madani, the terrorist who was arrested in Coimbatore blast case. Somehow he escaped the judiciary, and then he was again arrested for Bangalore Chinnaswamy Stadium explosion. Now, inside the jail, he has been given bail by Supreme Court, but he is asked to confine himself in Bangalore city. He cannot come to Kerala. But in Kerala, people have started collecting money through religious institutions, through mosques. Now, you cannot mosque for a political activity. Neither mosque, nor temple, nor church should be used for political purpose whatsoever. Collecting donations or distributing pamphlets, nothing is permitted. There is a criminal act called Religious Institutions Prevention of Misuse Act. So a religious institution cannot be misused for political purpose. But these people collecting money for Madani every Friday is a political activity. They themselves have declared that it is a political activity. Therefore, I lodged a complaint with the City Police Commissioner Kochi, and I was summoned there for making my statement. In fact, that itself is not required, but the police does that. I went there, I gave the statement. Then he drafted my petition in English is with him, but still he translated it into Malayalam and asked me to sign it. I said, no, I will not sign it. I have given you a signed petition. What is the one in signing the translation? And I don't agree with your translation. It's not. It does not reflect fully my arguments. Then the argument started. Finally, he said, let us wait for assistant commissioner to come. And assistant commissioner came after two hours. And he also asked me to sign. I said, what is this? I need not sign. I have given you a signed petition. I did not sign on the translation by your officer. Then he started shouting on me all sorts of filthy languages. Around 20 minutes, he was firing me. And then he left me. He said, don't allow this man to go out unless he signs the paper. I said, do whatever you want. I will not sign the paper. And I sent an SMS to one of my friends. He, along with two, three other people, came. They had an argument with the commissioner. Finally, I was released. Now, I started prosecution against this assistant commissioner. I filed a case in the lower court. I filed a case in the high court. Pardon?
Can you please state the name? Can you please state the name of the assistant commissioner?
I don't know whether he is in service or not. Now, by this time, he might have got retired. His name is Shamsu Illegal. Shamsu is the short name of Shamsuddin. Shamsu Illegal. Later on, I came to know that he was somehow connected with Abdul Nasir Madani. Anyway, that was his commitment to his Madani, which he showed. So I sued him in the lower court for harassing me. And in the high court, I said, I went with a writ petition saying that this type of money collection is going on. And when I complained, not only that police didn't institute a case, they acted against me. This was my case. And the high court took cognizance of that. They sent notice to the police and state of Kerala. The third step which I took was I lodged a complaint with the Human Rights Commission, State Human Rights Commission. So in all three directions, these cases were progressing. And the officer felt the heat. He said, I am prepared to apologize, this, that. I said, nothing doing. Nothing doing. I don't need your apology. Finally, Human Rights Commission, he was the retired Chief Justice of Kerala, J.B. Koshi. I had great respect for him. He told me, Mohandas, please take some compensation and finish off this issue. Let us not drag it further. I said, sir, but see, it was unbecoming of an officer to behave like this. If a drunkard is abusing me on the road, I will not go after him. I will say, stupid, somebody has abused you. Fine, jane do. He's a drunkard. We know that. And then this man is assistant commissioner of police, and inside his cabin, he is using filthy language against me. Then he said, anyway, we don't spoil his career, because I know if I write something bad about him, his career will end at this moment, which I don't want. Mohandas, please listen. And I have great personal respect for Justice Koshi. I said, okay, I'll heed to your request. By the time High Court has given instruction to police that register FIR on these collections, money collections, police registered FIR also. So I thought it's a fair deal. Fine. Now, it was only lower court which was pending. At any time, I can tell lower court that I have settled the case with the officer. So I used that. I took 3.5 lakhs for him, because, you know, it took 1.5 years for me and 8 advocates fighting for me in lower court and high court. I didn't pay them a single pie because I didn't have money. So I said, I need to pay total 3 lakhs for my advocates and 50,000 for me, because I have also taken pains, traveling, standing in the court, all these things. So, but the police officer was in a hurry to somehow come out of the case. Instead of 3.5, even if I asked 10 lakhs or 15 lakhs, he would have paid that, because it was his career which was at risk. But I don't want to treat it as a godsend, you know. You court order somebody, make money out of that, which I generally don't do. So I took 3.5 lakhs and finished off that matter. I withdrew the case, and that is how I fought it. But you know, it took me 1.5 years and 8 advocates in lower court and high court. In Human Rights Commission, you need not have an advocate. If you want, you can have. But Human Rights Commission is rather a non-judicial forum. Therefore, I argued my case alone. And mind you, I never told that this officer hit me or something like that. I told the Human Rights Commission the truth. What has happened? because Justice Koshi is known to me, if I tell him that this man hit me very badly, I was hit at my head, etc., he would have been believing it because he knows me as an honest man. I didn't take advantage of that. I told him this is what happened. For 20 minutes, he used all filthy languages against me. That is why I am in front of you. Justice Koshi specifically asked me, did he physically injure you? I said, sir, no. He did not. I could have told him, sir, he physically injured me. And no marking is to be shown because the case is 1.5 years old. And Justice Koshi knows me as an honest man. So I could have bluffed him. But I did not. That is what I told you, that be always truthful and honest. Honesty still has marks in our country, in our civilization, because India is a Hindu Rashtra. People value honesty. People value truth. Maybe you have some temporary setback here or there. Fight honestly, you will win definitely. And I hope my Tamil Nadu friends will understand this in the right spirit and continue with their fight, and I am with them. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mohandas ji. And I think we have one or two questions, and let's see if one question comes up. I saw one scroll. Here you go. Anandan Ramanathan wants to know, why is state police department always acting only in favor of the state government? Can't they see what is right or wrong? What is the role of center in such cases? Example, the wrong allegations of TN government at Maridas. I think he means Maridas and Kishore Swami. He is not saying that, but I think that's what he means. Please go ahead, sir.
See, law and order is a state subject. It is not a center subject. You take the constitution. There is state list, center list, and concurrent list. Law and order is in concurrent list. But for all practical purposes, it is a state subject because central government doesn't have any police force at their command. They have CRPF, BSF, and military with them. All three branches of the armed forces. They are with government. Local police is always by state government. If the state government requests, the central government can interfere. Otherwise, not. Otherwise, the central government has to dismiss the state government and take control of the situation. The only place which is exempted from this arrangement is New Delhi, because there are a lot of foreign embassies, foreign nationals in Delhi. You know, the American embassy is treated as American territory for legal purpose, not practical purpose, for legal purpose. Therefore, if you have a state police there and they act irresponsibly and intrude into American embassy or Switzerland embassy or Saudi Arabian embassy and create trouble there, what will happen? The country will lose international prestige. Therefore, only in New Delhi, the police is under the control of government of India. In all other states, it is under the control of state government. Naturally, they take orders from state government. Naturally, all their actions are in favor of the state government because state government is their boss. In fact, there is a Supreme Court judgment that police should become an independent authority, like, you know, Comptroller and Auditor General, Election Commission. All these things are constitutional authorities on which neither center nor the state have any control whatsoever. Maybe having some underground control, that is another thing, but constitutional, under constitutional scheme, these people are independent. Supreme Court is independent, High Court is independent, Election Commission of India, Accountant General of India, Controller and Auditor General of India. All these institutions are independent. There was a judgment by Supreme Court. Supreme Court gave a suggestion that you keep police also as an independent authority. But no politician wanted that, so it was not. Therefore, it is quite natural that whosoever is ruling a state, they will control the police also. And police force also has to succumb to the pressure of the politician, because it is an unimaginable pressure. You will be transferred, you will be suspended, you will be demoted. You know, with all said and done, life of a policeman is horrible. His duty is unregulated, you know. All we people have 8 hours duty, but a policeman cannot stop at 8 hours. If the next man doesn't come, he has to continue for another 8 hours. And still the next man doesn't come, he has to continue for another 8 hours. This way, people do duties for 48 hours, 55 hours, 60 hours in police. You have to do that. So, fearing this harassment, they succumb to political pressure of even local political leaders. This is what is happening. To come out of the situation, this is what Supreme Court said, that you make another authority, a police authority, which will be independent. Anyway, that has not happened. This is the status, and this is why things are happening in a way in which it is happening. Thank you.
That brings us to a close of today's program. I don't want to ask that question because that's not concerning malicious prosecution. Thank you very much, Mohandas ji. And viewers, I hope you got an idea. It is not so easy for someone to just arrest you, and that someone will be in hot water, and that will be some poor sub-inspector, probably acting on a phone call from his boss, who would have also got a phone call from his boss. You understand how this lame chain of command works. So if it is written, he's safe. Otherwise, there's a problem. But this has to be broken. I think the suggestion of the Supreme Court that it be a central appointment that cannot, and no politician in the states can touch the police, that's a very good idea. That will also pave way for an efficient force, because they are not beholden to anyone. This is something that should be seriously taken up by this government. Thank you once again, Mohandas ji, and Namaskar.
Thank you.